What made it very challenging was the age of the patient and also the peculiar anatomy of the aneurysm. It was very close to the renal arteries. Hi, I'm Dr. Arul Futaro, a consultant cardiovascular and thoracic surgeon at Apollo Hospitals, Banagatta Road, Bangalore. We had a very interesting case about a month back at Apollo Hospitals, Bangalore. This was a 75-year-old gentleman who had a diagnosis of an abdominal aortic aneurysm. He was referred to us from multiple other places. The reason being he had been through opinions which advised either open surgery, endovascular surgery. He was considered unfit for endovascular aneurysm repair. Then finally he came to us, and the team comprising of interventional radiology, cardiac surgery, vascular surgery, cardiology and cardiac anesthesia got together and thought that this patient could be best served by an endovascular repair. What made it very challenging was the age of the patient and also the peculiar anatomy of the aneurysm. It was very close to the renal arteries, which meant that a regular endovascular repair was difficult. So the team got together and thought about doing a fenestrated endovascular aneurysm repair. Now this is a procedure that is very infrequently done in this part of the country. And for us at Apollo Hospitals, it was a first of a kind. We went ahead and did the procedure by which we placed small stents through pre-made holes in the endovascular graft. These stents fed the renal arteries and made sure that the kidneys were functioning after the procedure. Now you would ask us, why not an open surgery for this gentleman? He had a few comorbidities which made an endovascular repair much better than an open repair. One was his age, his borderline renal function, and also he had some COPD, that is some lung dysfunction. An open surgery would have meant more time in the hospital, more morbidity, and a higher risk of mortality. And we at Apollo Hospitals, with the team approach, thought that a fenestrated endovascular aneurysm repair would work much better for him. And with this, we feel that we are much more geared up to deal with much more complex aneurysms of this nature, particularly abdominal aortic aneurysms, even thoracoabdominal aneurysms, and probably even straightforward aneurysms. And with the wonderful cardiology, interventional radiology, and anesthesia backup that we have, I think it would be pretty easy to deal with most of these aneurysms once they present to us. Thank you.